Hi everyone, it's me, Jean Moss. Welcome back to another episode of Painting at Home. I've got my coffee, I'm ready to do some art. We've got our canvas all set up, and I'm wearing a moss green shirt today. I invite you to look into your closet and find a piece that represents your name. Let's get started. If you've been tuning in the last couple of days, you'll know that first day we did landscapes, yesterday we did cityscapes. Today we're going to focus on seascapes, or under the sea. This is below the sea, as opposed to above it. I've come back to my vertical canvas. Now, I've been pointing out, and I would like to make that clear one more time, normally people would paint on a surface such as a canvas. You choose your surface. I invite you to look at cardboard as a possible surface. Clothing, whatever you find around your house can absolutely be a surface. I have found some sheets of recyclable paper and I've taped them together. This is my canvas on which anything is possible. Today we're going to focus on seascapes. I've got a few new items that we're going to add to our creativity sort of tool belt. So let's get started. I think we're going to have to start probably with the top of the water. I have a really fun new piece I want to use, and that is gaff tape. So I found some gaff tape. It's this beautiful blue color. Does everybody see that? Oh, it's just gorgeous, this beautiful blue color. We're just going to take that and create the top of our ocean. Now you can imagine whatever ocean you want to be. So I'm just going to start right here. My ocean has a nice straight line, and we're just going to travel across the top of the page there. And there's the top of our ocean. Now, one thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create, we've got the top, we've created a really nice perimeter there. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a wave shape above it. Today's also a very special day because I have a new ballpoint pen. If you watched in yesterday, you'll notice that my pen was running out of ink. But don't worry, I found an extra one around the house. So let's create this wave-like texture. If you've ever seen an ocean move, you'll know that the waves kind of go with the tides, right? So I'm gonna choose my waves to be going to the left. So that would mean then that the shore is on this side of my ocean. Let's get it going here. Here's one wave, and I'm gonna create a little loop-de-loo. Oh, perfection. All right, so there's one, and I might decide to make these waves a little bit different sizes, but it's entirely up to you. If you can see, these are sort of the wave shape. Now, I think what I'm gonna do is make them smaller as we get closer to shore. Oh, this looks great. Who knows, maybe there is a whale beaching. And finally, we have the smallest one, which is gonna go off the page just a hair, but that's okay because that it creates the illusion that the waves continue. This is already looking really wonderful. I'm very excited about this. All right, so we've got our wave shapes. Now we've got our ocean. I've never been in the ocean, but I can imagine that the ocean, there's just a whole world of possibilities, an entire world underneath the ocean. So I'm gonna go ahead and do something I've never done before. I'm gonna invite whoever is watching, what do you think of when you think of the ocean? Is it maybe a fish? Are you seeing a ship, a sunken ship, maybe a treasure? Completely up to you, but if I see things being written in, perhaps I will invite them into the world of my ocean. For me, what I see right off the bat is the bottom of the ocean. I believe there is a sandy structure. Now, I'm not gonna use my blue tape because the bottom of the ocean is a different color. I will outline it though with my ballpoint pen. Once again, we are drawing a seascape. This is Painting at Home with Jean Moss, that is my name, and we are drawing an oceanscape, or under the sea is our theme for today. So I've already created my water, right? And everything underneath is under the ocean. Everything above is above the ocean. So now I'm going to go ahead and draw what I think is at the bottom of the ocean, and I think it's sand. From what I've heard, it is sand. So I'm just going to create a little bit of a rolling sand structure. Oh yes, because I don't think it's flat sand. That I don't think. But I do think maybe there's a couple of layers to it. So I'm gonna draw kind of coming this way And then I'm gonna have these lines just kind of meet, oh, in the middle there. Oh, perfection. That looks great. So we have the top of our ocean, we have the bottom of our ocean, and I think it's really starting to come together. I'm really starting to see all the possibilities. Great, so I'm gonna put my pen away. Now, for those of you who tuned in yesterday, we had a very exciting treat. The first episode, I used ballpoint pen, I had some crayons, and for my paint, we had a little nail polish. Yesterday we had a glitter crayons, and I've brought those back today because they were just so much fun yesterday. And everyone just wrote to me and said, oh, Jean, we just loved the glitter crayons. They just brought so much joy to our day. So I brought them back today just on popular demand. And I'm gonna go ahead and open those guys up, crack them up open, and let's go ahead and get to shading. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and leave the top for a moment, and I think I'd like to start with the sand. Now, again, you can decide what color your sand is. I think I'm gonna stick to a word that I love. I just love this word. It is monochromatic. What that means is it's various shades of a similar color. So we've got green. I'm gonna use blue as well, sort of these cooler colors, right? I have a gray. We're gonna look at that gray. Oh, and this little rascal, remember this one from yesterday? This was called Blue Blazes. We used that in our cityscape. Remember we drew the city of Detroit? It was fantastic. So I'm gonna use these, various shades of gray. And then how about the gray glam? We used that color yesterday. It was just absolutely beautiful. So we're gonna go ahead and create a darker sand, and then we'll sort of lighten as the sun becomes more present at the top of our sea. So, okay, let's go ahead and get started. One other color I'd like to invite into our painting is a little brown. Now, we didn't use this one yesterday. It's a clean crayon, and I cannot get over these names on these crayons, my glitter crayons. This one is called, can everybody see that? Chocolate Sprinkles. Oh, imagine. And it looks like Chispas de Chocolate. That's another language there. I love these crayons. They teach you so much about other languages. Oh, and the various creativity and color naming. It is just vibrant. Okay, so we're gonna outline our sand just with a brown, just to get it started. And I'm just outlining the pen that I've already drawn in. Just outlining to create a little bit more texture to the top of our sand. Now, we've been talking a lot about textures. You play with various textures. It is up to you. So, I'm gonna just kind of create a little shading happening here. Now, we've talked also about shading. Specifically with this medium of art, with this Crayola crayon, you can create various textures just using a little more pressure on. And now, we did a stroke pattern yesterday. We stroked our painting, right? We stroked it as hard as we could for a river. I'm not gonna do that with the sand. I'll probably stick to that particular sort of movement with the water. So now I'm just kind of doing a little back and forth here. This can be found mostly if you've ever used a crayon before. I'm sure many of you have. You know, this is what we refer more as coloring, but I find that coloring is just another form of the painting process. So we're going to go ahead and just sort of do like a shading. Oh, just that's just turning out just wonderful. Just a shading pattern, shading technique, whatever you want to call it, completely up to you. So far, this is looking really nice. Now, we've gone ahead and shaded in. I'm going to use one of my other fantastic colors. I think I'm going to go, this is a new one we didn't use yesterday. It is called Lavender Burst. Just another terrific name for a coloring crayon. You can come up with your own names at home. I think if I were to name this one, I would call it Periwinkle Pleasure. I think that's what I would call it. But you come up with whatever name you want. And again, I'm just going back into that sort of coloring back and forth. It's very vigorous. Your wrist might get tired, so feel free to do a little roll around of the wrist. Stretch out your hands, whatever is good for you. Everybody's body is different. So we're gonna go ahead and just continue this little coloring. Oh yeah, that's coming in really nicely. Now, I have included the brown, but then the rest of the colors, we will go back to that monochromatic. Remember I said monochromatic is various shades of the same color, using such colors as black and white to either darken or lighten. Up to you though, if you want to make multiple colored sand, by all means. I'm sure we all know that rocks take various shapes and various colors. Oh, this is just turning out beautiful. I'm just gonna finish this off a little bit here. Under the sea is our theme today. We've been doing cityscapes, we've been doing landscapes. under the sea. Now, I don't know what time of year this is under the sea. I'm gonna let you decide. This is the top of our ocean. We've created that sort of structure using a new medium today. We used gaff tape, which is something I just happened to find around the house, and oh boy, how just creative my mind started to get when thinking of the possibilities of gaff tape. Okay, so we've colored in using, remember, I thought I might call this periwinkle pleasure, but what the actual name of this is lavender burst. And what I love about these crayons is I get glitter all over my hands. For those of you just tuning in, painting at home with Jean Moss, this is glitter crayon under the sea, but we're using glitter crayons today because I think I mentioned yesterday, I find that water is so sparkly and I think glitter crayons are just absolutely, absolutely the right material for water. Now I'm using a lighter blue. For those of you watching, this is Blue Blazes. We talked about this one. Again, very clever names in these Crayola crayons. I invite you to come up with your own names of color. Blue Blazes, who knows? Maybe it's Blue Blast for you. It can be anything you want it to be. Okay, we're doing a coloring just sort of back and forth here to fill in that shade. Oh, that's wonderful. Great, let's do one more color just to give it that added texture. I have, this is Grey Glam. We used this one yesterday in our water. We're gonna come back to it just to kind of blend everything. We're blending. The sand can be many colors. Sand, for those of you who don't know, sand is actually just breakdown of rock. It's erosion and breakdown of rock from water. So sand is actually very colorful. If you've ever seen sand up close, which I have not, but if you have, you can tell that it's very different colors. Great, so we've got our shading in. This is really looking nice. Let's go ahead and check out the water up at the top here. So I'm gonna imagine there's some sunlight at the top of our ocean. From some of the photos I've seen, that seems true. Now, I'm gonna pull out a new crayon. We did not use this one yesterday, but this one is called Night Sky. Maybe this is a night painting. I don't know, it's up to you. But let's find out what this color really is. So I'm gonna just outline, oh, that's a rich, deep blue color, Night Sky. Now, this is somewhere between blue and navy. For those of you just tuning in, we're using Night Sky to create our waves. So this crayon is just a very deep blue, almost a cobalt type blue. Some might even call it navy. You call it whatever you want. It's entirely up to you. We see colors so differently, I've found. I'm just outlining my waves. As you all know, we're drawing a seascape today, or under the sea. So this is actually below the sea. A seascape would be above the sea, but we're gonna call it a seascape anyway to stay on theme. So I've outlined with this beautiful night sky is this color. And I know I have a different blue in here. I just wanna make sure we're capturing all the various blues we can use because it's such a rich color. This one is called, how perfect, Aqua Fizz. Oh boy, what will they think of next? I don't know, but I'm gonna shade in. And I'm just using that back and forth stroke of my crayon. Now, you use whatever you want. I am using this. You could, let's get a little creative here. You could do one of these, right? This creates a little more movement for the wave. A little more movement. Oh, that's filling in real nice. I'm gonna leave this side of the wave a little bit lighter. I think it captures the sunlight. So, I love this, just sort of up and over. This really makes me think of the movement of the waves. So we're gonna go ahead and just continue on with that. Color that, and oh, that looks great. And how about some of these bigger waves? Oh, these are bigger strokes. We talked yesterday about that stroking pattern with your hand, and I think it just creates a lot of texture, a lot of shape to your photo, to your picture, to your painting, whatever you want to call it. But I've left the other side. You'll notice a little bit whiter. I like to imagine my sun is maybe dipping on the water. That's my reflection and coming up onto the wave. Very just illusions and textures, whatever you want to call them. We're almost done with our surface here. And then we'll come back to under the sea. Now, I was inviting the people watching at home, whatever comes to mind with you and under the sea, please write in and I will see if I can invite that into my world. I know there are fish. I've never personally been under the sea, but I've certainly seen the Little Mermaid more times than I can count. And I know there are fish, maybe crabs, maybe even a mermaid. If you want to write in what you find under the sea, perhaps we can include it in this wonderful painting. Or if you would prefer just to create something at home, something that's just you and the way you see under the sea. All right, let's finish up this little rascal over here. This little wave right here, our biggest wave. Oh, and just following the leader with these waves. Okay, so we've created our shading pattern. Now we have done two different kinds of strokes today. We've done the back and forth, and then we've done this big wave structure. So we're gonna just go ahead and stay on that. And now we're finally able to come to under the sea. This is wonderful. So let's create a few things. Now, one thing I see under the sea is a giant treasure chest. Oh, of course I do. Oh, I would see that. I'm always just the optimist, aren't I? So this one is called Black Gold. We did use this one just a little bit yesterday in our cityscape. Yesterday, for those of you who did not tune in yesterday, we did a cityscape of the great city of Detroit. It worked out very well. It was just absolutely wonderful. So I'm gonna go ahead and draw my treasure chest. Now, I imagine, how far are we under the sea? Probably not so far. So my treasure chest is gonna be a little larger. Let's go ahead and draw that right over here. And I'm just gonna draw a straight line up, up. Maybe a straight line up here. Maybe it's behind this little sand, just a little bit. Ah, fantastic. Great. And now we have a line across. This is our treasure chest, just the beginning. For those of you who don't know what a treasure chest is, it's often found in sort of a tale of pirates, right? Where they would steal things like gold and jewels and such, and and fill them in a chest. So my treasure chest might have some gold, some jewels. Now, for those of you who don't know what I'm doing, I'm creating sort of a box-like structure. This is a pretty advanced technique. It's a 3D box. So what this means is that my box is probably turned a little bit this way. So that's what we've created. And now, for those of you who have ever seen a treasure chest, I only ever have in books and movies and things, but it's got a rounded top, right? And it's gonna create a little bit of a wave to it. Yes, that's beautiful. So I'm just drawing this, and I'm using crayon, and I chose this specifically. Normally I might use my ballpoint pen, but I'm using crayon just specifically because I wanted to show you that drawing outline shapes is also possible with crayon. Don't forget that. That's not just a ballpoint pen move. Great, so we've got this, and now I think this just kind of goes across the top there and opens up, and oh, there we go. Fantastic. That's our sort of treasure chest right there, and it closes. Oh, it closes over all that gold those silly pirates tried to steal. Great. So I'm showing you that you indeed can draw outlines, right, with crayon. We've never really done that before, but we're doing that now. Great. And let's just make sure we have that outline of our box. Oh, this is just coming together really very nicely. Wonderful. I'm going to thicken this up a little bit. Great. And one thing we also talked about yesterday was a little bit of shading. Now, we'll get to that in a moment because I want to get to my gold as soon as possible. I'm going to use a different crayon. This one is, I think we used this one yesterday, it's called Golden Dust. Right, so Golden Dust, another amazing name. I can't. Alright, so I'm going to just start to draw little circles. This is my golden chest. And for those of you who don't know what I'm doing just a little circular movement. We did this in clouds a few days ago. You can also apply this to coins. It works very well. I promise, it works just like a dream. Now again, I'm doing the counterclockwise. You choose, you can do clockwise, whatever works for you. I might have a few coins spilling over. It is under the water, of course. And maybe just across here. This is coming together very nicely. Wonderful. Okay, and as you can see now, I'm going to start to do bigger moments because under the water it gets a little bit fuzzy. You probably don't need to tell or can't really tell the coin specifically. This is really filling in very nicely. Now we get to choose my favorite thing. We get to choose the color for our treasure chest. Actually, what I think I might do, I envision red. This is where the fun part comes in. We are going to use paint. Right, so we're gonna use paint to paint our chest, and I think it's a little bit of a red. Now, normally I do sort of an interesting brush stroke, a little bit staccato movement. I think I'm gonna just change it up a little bit, do something a little bit different here. Oh, look at that, that's great. Oh, that's wonderful. I'm creating a little bit of a line, maybe just a design or two. Up to you. Whatever you want to use for your treasure chest, it's your chest. And you can do whatever you want with it. Oh, that's nice. Coming together very nicely. All right. Okay. Now, I'm going to quickly just check on our comments here. Ah, fantastic. If anyone has any ideas, I have a comment for a chest full of scarves. Now, that is another thing one can put in a chest. Chests are really for anything you want them to be. So, again, I'm creating just a little movement here. You can put scarves, you can put jewels, you can put furs maybe. Oh, furs in a chest. How absolutely luxurious would that be? I've never seen it, but I can imagine it. We all can. Look at that. We're outlining our chest here. This is looking really wonderful. I've put coins in my chest. Up to you. But for the sake of just making sure our viewers feel seen and heard, perhaps I will add a scarf. And I'm going to use this wonderful color for my scarf. It is called Crimson Clash. How appropriate. How appropriate. All right, so here's my scarf. And maybe my scarf, falling out of my chest, has a little wave to it, a little movement. And then look at this. I'm going to get crazy and draw a little fringe on the end of that scarf. And to complement my Crimson Clash, I have a darker shade of nail polish. I'm going to color that right in. Oh, the scarf was a good choice. Whoever wrote that at home, your imagination is just full of surprises, isn't it? Full of surprises. Okay, so we've colored that in a little darker. Those of you just tuning in, we have a chest here full of gold coins and a scarf. Now we're going to move on to what sorts of wildlife lives underneath our sea. I am sure I've heard of a horse living under the sea before, so why don't we go ahead and draw a horse under the sea? What would a seahorse look like? I'm going to take a stab at it. I think a seahorse, probably has, let's put our seahorse, maybe he lives over here. Maybe that little rascal lives over here. I'm going to put him right there. He's got a rounded head and probably his horse nose. Look at that. Let's make him a smiling horse. Oh, yeah. There's his horse nose. Now, again, I've shown you today that you can also outline with crayons. I usually use a ballpoint pen, but crayons are absolutely possible as well. So go ahead and use your imagination. Now, my seahorse has a little smile on his face. He's happy to be under the sea. Okay, how about a nice mane? Great. And I've chosen the color green because when you go below water, things start to adapt to whatever environment they're in. So cooler colors tend to live under the water. So we're drawing a seahorse for those of you joining us at home. And I think from a photograph I've seen, they've got rounded bodies and then a little curly tail there. Let's just get that going. Maybe he's got a little arm, a little hand. Hello. Probably hand is waving at some sort of fish over there. We'll get to that later. Oh, and there's our seahorse. Oh, that's just beautiful. Very good. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just kind of color this in. Oh, it's coming alive. Now, I imagine because I've seen land horses before, never seen a seahorse. But let's pick up, how about Aquafizz?
This is it. Everyone ready?
And we're going to just go ahead and draw our mane on our horse. It seems you must wonderful.
Find the truth.
Here we go. Now we've got that mane going. Oh, and here's our daily advertisement. Feel free to listen. It's a nice distraction. Nice distraction while you start to kind of decide what color mane maybe your seahorse has. Okay, so we're giving him sort of a... I think this looks like a modern mane. This looks wonderful. So here's our seahorse. Now let's make sure our seahorse isn't completely eyeless. So I'm going to find night sky one more time and we're going to draw, there's Mr. Eye right there. We've got the smile. Let's just kind of outline that a little bit further. There's our smile, our seahorse. For those of you joining us, this is Seascapes. Under the sea. You are painting at home. I am Joan Moss and I am drawing a seahorse. My seahorse has these little hands, but they're waving. And soon we'll get to some more wildlife. If you have any suggestions for wildlife under the sea, I recommend you go ahead, write those in. I would love to hear Now I'm doing a little shading. I'd love to hear what you find under your sea. I'm going to shade this horse in. Great. All right, we've got a few more items to fit into our little under the sea here, but I'm just kind of shading this in. But I'm going to leave, and I've shaded it in such a way that I'm creating pressure a little bit just to create a shade, right? So let's go ahead and read in. I've seen that people would like to see a shark. Now, for those of you who don't know, a shark is a little bit more aggressive of an animal. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put our shark maybe a little bit lower. Maybe our shark is after the chest of scars and gold. So let's go ahead and draw that in. Now, as you know, there are various types of sharks. Let's stick with the sharks that we know. How about a hammerhead shark? What a good idea. So I'm gonna draw the hammer. Here's the hammer. Oh yes, this is a big guy. Now, we have our seahorse, we have our hammerhead. For those of you who don't know, I'm using now, this is one of my favorites, Tropical Shower. How cozy and warm do you feel with the name of that color? That is just terrific. Okay, so here's our hammerhead shark. Here's his long body. And let's create, I believe sharks have this fin at the top, right? And he's got this long body. And then they have what's called a rear fin. That's what it's called. And so I'm drawing again. And here is our shark. This is going just beautifully. Now he's just coming into the picture. So I've cut off his fin to show that he's not all the way in this world. That means though that the sea expands beyond just this photo. It's amazing, isn't it? Great, so we've got our shark now. Let's give him a little bit of eyes. And today, for those of you tuning in, I am using crayon just to show that you can outline as well with crayon. But just to go back to our normal outline resource, I often use, that's my old pen. I often use just a simple ballpoint pen. You can find this anywhere at home, it's very simple. So I've just outlined a little bit and I'll kind of go back here. Wonderful, I'm just gonna go back and outline. And what I'm gonna do is draw in the eyes with my ballpoint pen. I don't think hammerheads, oopsie, we lost a crayon there. I don't think hammerheads have smiles on their faces, but they do have what's called gills. This is how they breathe. So we're gonna draw in a gill there, and a gill there, and a gill there. I'm just outlining. Again, we've come back to the pen, and there's our gill. So we have our hammerhead shark, we have our seahorse. So wonderful, I'm gonna go ahead and shade in Mr. Hammerhead over here. Oh, Mr. Cranky Pants, I like to call him. I'm gonna use our black gold again, just a little bit to kind of show that this is a darker creature, right? This creature is out. And I'm using, once again, this sort of quick motion with it. It's very fast. You might see this if you've ever colored before. Some of you may have. But you know what you could also do is our quick movement, right? This is a quicker, more aggressive animal. Maybe I might, just for a little texture, a couple of those little blips. And you know I like to make noise when I do that. I do, I really do. I am gonna draw just a little bit of the fin. Oh, that's very beautiful. Now, I'm just kind of trying to create an extra little shape because the fin, right, moves a little bit differently than the rest of the body. So we want to capture that. Good, so now I'm gonna do my look, just get a little texture. And this is looking just wonderful. Let's color in Mr. Fin over here, the top fin. Wonderful. This is really coming together. I did not expect the hammerhead to be a part of our world today, but I'm really glad it became a part of our under the seascape because it's adding such a different color, isn't it? Oh yeah, that's wonderful. All right. Okay, so we have one final thing. I'm sure, I'm certain of it, that there are absolutely trees under the sea. There's a whole just plant life under the sea that we don't see very often, but when we do, it is wonderful. So I'm gonna go ahead and draw my tree. Couple things, I know there are some plants. Actually, what I think I wanna use, I'm feeling a little frisky today. I have found another little new sort of medium we're gonna use today. It's an old bottle of mascara. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna draw, see if this works. Oh yeah. Oh, look at these plants coming alive. It's an old bottle of mascara. So it's not as liquefied as some of the newer bottles. I don't often wear it, so I don't buy it that much. I think this was a friend of mine's, but what a great use of texture with that mascara. Do you see what's coming alive over here? Oh, wow, this is just really something. This is coming alive just beautifully. And we'll outline it a little bit later. What I want to get is the texture. This is just a plant that we're going to start to draw. Look at, now the plant goes outward maybe a little bit, and we'll use crayon to fill that in as well. Wonderful. So we're using a little bit of mascara. Now if you spin the brush around, that'll give you full access to all the paint or all of the mascara on the brush. So I recommend you do that. Just make sure you use up all your resources. Great, so that's a wonderful sort of way to create some texture. Let's go ahead and outline that. I'm gonna jump in to one of my older Crayola crayons. This is a non-glitter crayon. This is our green, or Verde, as we've talked about. But I'm gonna go ahead and just get some structure in here. Just outline what we've already got going. This is just beautiful. And let's create just a little, oh yes. Now, this is more of a sketch quality that we're using. So I'm sketching, and we're coming up here on Mr. Seahorse. This is wonderful. All right, we're getting there. Okay, so now you can see how the marker really kind of, or rather the crayon, really sort of blends with our texture from that mascara. That looks really nice. So that's our plant, and then we have our one final thing to draw, my friends, and that is our tree. Now, as you know, I always like my trees to feel very grounded. So I'm gonna go ahead and draw my rocks. I love when trees are rising out of a hard place. Don't you love that? So we're going to go ahead and draw our rocks now. Here's one rock, and it's gonna go behind the chest, and then how about another one? Right behind our shark here. Right behind, that looks great. So now our shark, oh, is gonna run right in that rock if he's not careful. Oh dear, that silly shark. Who knows what sharks are thinking? We never know. We've got our two rocks, which is what I love, right? Let's go ahead and shade those in just to get those bad boys started. Here we go, here's our rocks. I'm using my, which one is this again? This is our chocolate sprinkles. I love that name. I could eat this crayon. I could eat it right up, chocolate sprinkles, as I'm drawing my rocks here. And I'm going back to that sort of, oh, now I'm gonna use this pattern because I like the movement it creates in the crayon. This is just wonderful. Okay, and how about this rock? Let's color that bad boy in. There it is, a little rascal over here. And we're gonna just kind of create a little shadow. We talked about that earlier, a little shadow behind the shark. Here's our shark, here's our shadow. And again, hopefully Mr. Shark does not drive into those rocks. There's our rocks. Let's draw our tree. What kind of tree are we drawing today? We've done, let's see, a weeping willow. We've done a palm tree. I think what lives under this ocean is a beautiful, oh, let's say, oak tree. I don't know if oak trees live underneath the ocean. Let's say they do. You can have whatever tree live under your ocean. Now, I've created my rocks. I'm gonna go ahead and create the stump first. I always like the stump, and as you know, my stumps are always pretty thick. There's a thick stump right there. And they're never fully straight. I think trees have a lot of life, right? So my stump is usually a little bit curvy. There we go. Oh, wonderful. So this is my thicker stump, which I love because it just, I think, represents a little bit of strength. Let's outline that. Ooh, using Aqua Fizz again. We love a blue stump. Why not? Your stump can be whatever color you want it to be. It is up to you. I get people writing in all the time and they say, you know, Jean, you love putting trees in your paintings. Well, trees represent life, and I love life, and I think our tree has maybe a little age to it. So I'm just gonna draw in a couple of things here just to represent texture and age. And now why don't we go ahead and color that in, and I'm gonna go back. Oh, I love this color. Remember, I had called this periwinkle pleasantries. I can't remember what I called it, but I think it was something like that. And this one is actually called Lavender Burst. So we're gonna just go ahead and fill that right in because we have a blue stump, right? We have a blue stump in our tree today, and then we'll draw the top. Now, for those of you who don't know what oak trees look like, they have lots of very beautiful leaves. I believe Canada, I've never actually been to Canada, but they have lots of oak trees up in Canada. Lots and lots. I invite you to check it out. If you ever have time to Google an oak tree, please Google an oak tree. It's very wonderful. I'm gonna create a little shadowing down here. Now again, I'm using this coloring sort of sketch-like motion, right, with my hand. Yesterday we focused on stroking, right, stroking our painting. Maybe I'll use a little stroking here with my stump. Yes, my trunk. Big trunk right there, all good. Okay, let's get right to the top of that tree. Oh, what color will we be using today? Now, our oak tree, we've said, has lots of different leaves. It's also very circular at the top. So we're gonna jump back in with, oh, gritty green, which was a popular color in our cityscape yesterday of Detroit. So here's a little leaf right there. And you can draw a bunch if you want, but what I'm gonna do is just draw like an outline. So here's my outline with leaves. Great, this is wonderful. Let's create a leaf right here and right here. This is different from our other trees. I usually do a rounded top, and we're going to stick with that idea because that's what trees look like. But I'm going to just sort of get a little crazy with this one today because it does live under the sea, and things are a little crazier under the sea, aren't they? Here we go. Coming around, and look at that. Oh, that's just gorgeous. And get those leaves in there. I'm going to do maybe like a little up, 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 up. This is a different stroke pattern because I'm going in a little bit of a circular pattern. Look at that. Oh, look at what that is doing. That tree looks like it just has movement. And you can see it's moving with the waves. Do you see that? There is motion under the sea, indeed. Indeed there is. Great. Now I'm using gritty green to kind of go with our cooler color scheme, right? And let's just get some of that in there. This looks wonderful. Now, some of you might be wondering, how are you gonna color in the background? This is where it gets fun. I'm gonna pull out one of these crazy crayons. Oh, how about one we haven't used yet? Let's see, what's this one? Poppin' purple, why not? Why not? I think we're just gonna go a little crazy here. Let's try something new. Let's just do lines. Lines. This is going to blend everything together with poppin' purple. Lines. Oh, yes. I invite you to create different textures with your paintings. Today, we're going to blend everything with lines. Just a simple straight across. We've got our shark, our chest of gold and scarves, and just lines. Look at that, fills it right in. Now, you can use one color. You know what I'm going to do, though? I'm a little frisky today. I'm going to use two colors. How about that? Let's see. I'm going to go back to my aqua fizz. I just love that name. So effervescent. So we're just going to go back to aqua fizz. Now we've got sort of a blue color and a purple color. Just lines. Today is all about the lines. You think about the lines in your life. Maybe it's a line of fruit. Maybe it's a line at the grocery store. Probably not now. Maybe it's a kick line. Oh, I love the kick line. Find the lines in your life. This is beautiful. All right, we've got one final thing to do, friends, and that's coloring in the sky. I think we've decided it's evening, so I think I'm gonna find, oh, one of these darker blue colors. Let's see which one we find. How appropriate. Night sky is the color of this one. And we sort of talked about it. I'm gonna continue with my lines up above the ocean. Night sky, just above the ocean. Very beautiful. I'm gonna continue with the lines, staying continuous. What I love about the lines is the lines above and below are starting to blend above the water, below the water. It's beautiful. What a lovely concept. Concept of togetherness. Here we go. Finishing up with our lines here. And let's get one more little color up here just to kind of tie everything together. This is our black gold. I love that color. How appropriate too. Blackness, but also brightness. Fantastic idea for a night sky. Now again, this is all for me. This is my work. Let me put a little black on the bottom too. Don't try to copy anyone's work. Just do your work. Whatever you want to do is absolutely right in the world of art. Okay. I get a lot of people who say, Gina, I had no idea I could paint at home. I had no idea you could paint at home. That's the brilliant thing about painting, is it's very portable. Do wherever you want to do it. Wherever you can set it up. Anywhere you want to. In the park. A pizzeria, maybe. I don't know. You decide. Okay. There's one final thing I want to include here, just a couple, and that's bubbles. I love bubbles. How about a bubble there? How about a bubble there? And a bubble there? Maybe me by Mr. Sher. And we're just finishing up here. Those of you tuning in, this has been Painting at Home. I'm Jean Moss. We are painting under the water today. And I invite you to look under the water near you. Maybe it's in the bathtub. Looking at the world, looking at nature. Whatever you see that you want to draw, you draw it. We're including bubbles. You might include a couple of darker bubbles, maybe of the green color. Let's do it. Why not? We're using glitter crayons today, friends, because the water sparkles, as we all know. And we're just finishing up here our under the water seascape. We have our seahorse, our tree, our hammerhead shark, and of course our chest of golden scarves. Let's go ahead and zoom in and take a look at this work of art. Makes me think of what under the sea might be like. I love that. Thank you all so much for joining me. Once again, this has been Painting at Home. I'm Jean Moss, here for you. I invite you to look under the sea, look at your landscape, look at your cityscape, just escape with art. Tune in again for another episode tomorrow. Have a wonderful Wednesday.